Okay. I start with the first and an interesting question about the Diwali gift. Shashank, we had a variety of Diwali gifts this year. Thank you so much for that. And one of the observations was that my friend got the gift that was allocated to him. But when I asked for something, I got the default gift, not the gift of my choice. Why?
Are we just working? Can you hear me?
Yes.
We just recognize Amit Savli for being such a great procurement person. This question was very, it's an important question to take. And I'll give you some numbers. We procured gifts for over 1,850 employees, 1,865 employees to be exact. We opened up the portal for people to select one from five gifts. Last year we had four gifts and we had to select one. In the previous year we used to have no option. You know, we used to one standard gift, one size fits all, goes to everybody. So now imagine the logistical challenges that we have. You know, there is a very small team of procurement, HR, which works together to bring all of this together. The portal was open for 8 days. It was supposed to close on 25th of September. Of the 1,865 people, 75 people made no choice. That 75 people constitutes about 3%, you know, of people. So 3% people did not make a selection. For those people who did not make a selection, either they did not submit when they were selecting on the tool, or they did not just go on the site, or possibly they did it after the 25th. And we had a hard cutoff because we had to procure and get the stuff in here and be able to deliver it on time. So those 75 people by default got the default gift. Now, I don't know whether it is fair for them or not. My ask is that there's no obligation for BMC to give the Diwali gifts. It is not part of our employment contract. If Sameer does not give me a gift, I'm not going to say, Sameer, you did not. You gave it to Raj, but it's not you. But either way, Sameer gave the gift to both of us. You have to be ninja for that. This is the best place to be. Right? So one part. And on a serious note, you know, I would also say this, I'm going to move the wine a little bit right now. That there was so much of negativity with this 3% people who did not execute on their responsibility. Which was simple responsibility to go check on a gift that they wanted. That they spoiled the festival for the people who organized it. Also people did not have the patience, like for example, if Sameer got the gift, I'm sitting next to him. There's a process, right? There's a manager who's supposed to hand over the gift to the employee. So possibly his manager was quick enough to get the gift and then hand it over. And my manager was not there and therefore I would have gotten the next day. But I didn't have the patience. I would start pinging. By the time the ping goes there, I also call and then I walk up to the person concerned and say, where is my gift? So again, I'm backtracking saying that. It's a large operation. It requires a lot of logistics. There are very crisp timelines to execute on because we can't get late. And therefore, my ask and request is for a little bit more considerate to people who manage it. Everybody, by the way, has got gifts. Everybody has got. Or if they have not received, if the gifts are waiting here for you to go collect if you were not there on that day. So long answer. I always promise to give an answer. You may or may not like it.
Thank you so much, Sasha. And before we proceed, I'll just make a disclaimer. I'm just a messenger over here. So we shoot the message and not the messenger. I'll move on to Raj. So Raj, with the change in the CEO at the corporate level, can we expect BMC to start being proactive on product design features, or will we continue focusing on reacting to the market changes? We are already behind in technology and features. What is the belief of R&D leadership team in India on the change in the market requirements?
So, by the way, to be honest, I took some time to digest that question because we were not waiting for the CEO to react to the product in the market, right? So, in fact, we have been quite responsive in my mind in terms of reacting to the challenge. So, if you look at the whole DSOM merge, right, the first thing that we did was to essentially bring the whole ITOM portfolio to SaaS. I mean, I think Siddharth covered that. So, it was not that we were sitting. So, maybe there's something behind the question that I didn't quite understand. But we clearly have been looking at market trends at our position to make sure that we are reacting to the markets, right? We can't afford not to, right? We can't afford not to. And to be honest, what we don't really give ourselves credit is that our products have the longevity which others crave for, right? It's not it's not very common to find a product that's been around for 20 plus years. So you should not be really ashamed of that. It's a great matter of pride that our products have survived in this industry with such a rapid change for so many years, right? So, and it does not happen if you just had a product which is not getting a constant care and feed, right? So that's really a key aspect of it. Now, in terms of the new CIO, I know Shishan said, hey, we have a new CIO, and they just came, sorry, CEO who just came in. One interesting fact, which I probably don't know if all of you know this, but all our previous CEOs have come from a sales background. And Ayman actually comes from a product background, right? So all the deep dives so far have been actually been focused on product and architecture, which was kind of different in terms of our reaction to our typical CEO's deep dives, right, Ayman? So that's been very refreshing in my mind. And I'm sure we'll be doing more towards retooling the product and improving the product. It's not that we are sitting on our hands, right? So I think we definitely will be doing more of it. But I just wanted to make sure that you all understood that it was not that we're waiting for the CEO to do this.
Thank you, Raj. Okay, so the next question is about the employee referral policy. We have a very interesting employee referral policy. Everyone knows that?
Yes.
If you refer an employee, you get a good bonus for that. Yeah? Which is good for 1 month at least. So the question is, my entire family wants to join BNC. However, the policy says that an employee referring a relative is not eligible for referral amount as per the policy. If not full amount, at least some amount should be awarded to the referring employee. So, the question is why we don't get a bonus when an employee refers his relative.
Well, I think you should ask the referred employee to give you a nice dinner after you have rewarded the person referred. The global policy in BNC is we do not encourage employees to be hired within the same organization, within the same VP or SVP's organization. And that is where this policy stems from. So every time we hire a relative, it's an exception. And obviously, we can't reward for an exception. You know, this is one of the best places to work for in India. Okay, your colleagues, your relatives might be wanting to work for it. I think it's a reward by itself. You know, and the fact is that you will have your relative working there. It gives you a nicer ambience to be at BNC. So I don't think you need to get rewarded monetarily. You know, obviously, your referred employee will give you a dinner or whatever.
Thank you so much, Shashan. We'll open up the questions for the audience at this point in Pune. Any questions in the audience? Please raise your hand so that Vaibhav can reach out to you. Bangalore team, any questions from Bangalore? Okay, I'll move on with the... There's a question. Please avoid your hands going near the hair. It would give an impression you want to ask a question. Okay, so next... Okay, Manoj is asking a question and I think it's from Bangalore.
There's a question from Pune itself. So, we had spoken about a car policy a couple of years back and had parked it due to GST implementation. Are we still considering implementation of the CART policy? And if yes, by when can it be launched?
The CART policy is in the cold storage. Vikas and I have had some discussion to bring it out. We'll let you know. This is still not on our prime agenda to bring. There are still complications that are there. We're exploring options of company car lease policy as well as a private car lease policy. You will hear it at an appropriate time. Right now, we're not ready for it.
Thank you, Shashank. So the next question is for both of you. So the person who asked this question said that he has joined BMC recently and he's noticed that the culture is really favorable over here. However, in the past 7 months, that was closely observed was that there are many senior resources who are leaving from DSO. And for BMC, these resources were having at least 10 years of experiences, and this was their first company that they had joined. It's a big loss to the company is what the person claims. And outside of BMC, the impression is one who joins BMC rarely leaves it. Now, I sincerely understand that everyone has their own career goals and priorities. However, and now the question started. So this was the 150 words question. However, are we concerned about this and how are we going to balance this knowledge gap? I'll give it to Raj first and then we'll move on to Shashank.
So I think if I say that I'm not concerned about attrition, then I should not be in this position. So absolutely, attrition is a concern, but it's also something that I don't think we can ever say we'll never have attrition. Right? That's a natural course of action. So so attrition is natural. Though we will obviously try our best not to have attrition, especially on critical talent, right? But having said that, I don't think attrition, I heard about the concern. At the macro level is something that I'm losing sleep right now. At least it's been fairly stable in terms of the overall metrics. I know it might have happened in some instances that we're losing good talent. But at the macro level, I would still say it's a pretty healthy retention rate that we have. And a pretty engaged workforce. So while yes, I mean attrition, some attrition does cause hurt, but I don't think it's at a level that we should lose sleep. That at least from my perspective. Love to hear your thoughts.
I think it's a good question, though. It's a long question, but it's a good question. And the answer is also there in the question, which says that you know people have their own career aspirations and priorities, and that is what determines whether you stay or you go. So that's one part of it. But I think the other and more important part is that let's realize where are we. We are in India, where there could be debate about what the growth rate of India right now. GDP is 6%, 7%, depending on who's speaking what. It is still faster than you know many other countries in the world. And what does it mean? The rate or the faster rate of GDP means that there is that much more opportunity. Now, BMC is a great place here, and people come and drop anchors and build skills and build careers here, which also makes them attractive in the market. And it's a good thing. I know that there are so many companies which give out mandate to headhunters to say, go hire from BMC. You know? And I think it's a good thing to happen because it tells us that we have good quality people here. And if nobody is leaving here, that would mean that, you know, you guys are not desired anywhere else. You know, the fact that just about 11 or 12% people leave from here is a big credit in a market where attrition is over 15 to 20%. So the better question to ask is why do people stay at here? Rather than saying why do some people leave here? If you look at that number, 12% of attrition, 88% people believe that there is better career available at BMC and they stay. And the other part, yeah, of course, people in the recent time we've had some trend of people with tenured BMC experience leaving the company. I think it's all about time and context and stage of their own life and their own personal calling preferences that they said as part of the question there. So like Raj said, I don't think we are unduly worried about it. We constantly focus on attrition and more than attrition, we focus on retention. And trying to see what creates better retention for the kind of people that we want for BMC in the future. And with BMC Patshala, the Kaksha 1.0 and 2.0 programs that we're running right now, we're making sure that we are skilled for the future. And there is possibility that some people might feel that their skills are not getting aligned or their career priorities are not getting aligned with what we're trying to drive here. And so as a natural process of evolution, some people will leave and more people will join.
Wow, thank you so much. This was one of the most toughest questions that was there, which we had received, and I'd like you to applause for both of them. Thank you. And that does not mean that we don't have interesting questions. This was toughest. So the interesting question now to Shashank is, so we already have work from home policy. How about reimbursing the internet connection charges in the question?
All right, okay. Work from home is a flexibility that is available. It's a shared responsibility. What's the price of internet today? You know, most of you carry data on your mobile phones, which you are not able to consume at a small price. I think the amount that we're talking about, and I respect the sentiment because, you know, you think that you're doing work for the company and therefore needs to be reimbursed. But the fact of the matter is the company is also giving me the opportunity to be flexible and to be able to work from anywhere, anytime. So I think we should not try to monetize. I mean, that's my personal view on it and I don't want to be sermonizing on it, but I don't think we should monetize every benefit that comes to you and say, how do I get something out of it? Realize that it's also helping your own life to be able to work from anywhere. And then the fact remains that internet has become ubiquitous. Will you be able to draw a line, for example, to say, you know, 10 GB of data was for work and another 2 GB was watching Netflix? You know, Vikas will have a tough time to pay that. He say that, you know, how much was Netflix and how much was VPN? So, the clear answer on that, we are not going to be reimbursing broadband expenses. Sorry. And, we should thank Mukesh Ambani. Made it.
Thank you, Shashank. Are there any questions in the audience at this point? We just have 3 more minutes remaining. Bangalore team, there's a question. Okay. So Raj, this question is about the future of services in SaaS world and there are no on-site deployments and upgrades. And with teams integrated with support done, can we also expect SaaS support, which is LX, to get integrated soon, bringing all of the support under one umbrella?
Of course, I mean, I'm sure there is a lot of angst in sense of what's going to happen, right, with the move to SaaS. But let me just tell a few things. And this was a big discussion even in the QBR, NACIS QBR that we had last week about services, right? So I just had a good discussion today morning with Nilo. So when you talk about, hey, customers moving to SaaS, let's also see what's the reality today, right? Today, at least for Remedy, we have 2,000 plus customers. Total overall, of which only 250 customers are on our SaaS platform. That means the vast majority of the customers are still not on our SaaS platform, right? So I don't think we are at a stage where we have to say, hey, on-prem is completely gone and we don't have any, we don't have to think about or worry about on-prem, right? So we still have a significant presence in on-prem that we cannot ignore. Let's just be clear about that. But it also means that we also have a great opportunity, especially in our services arm, to see how we can help those customers move to SaaS, right? Because market has already proven that the trend is for real, right? It's not a fad, it's a real trend. The customers are moving to SaaS, right? I mean, the migration has been going on for a while now and it's just going to accelerate. So it's in our best interest and it's a lot of business to be made if we can help our customers do the transformation, right? I mean, do the transformation from on-prem to SaaS. So there is a lot of opportunity for our services teams to think about how they can do that help, where they can lift the customer from on-prem to the SaaS. So there's a ton of opportunity still out there, right? And in terms of how, what does the future look like, when we, how do we integrate on-prem and SaaS, I would say that's a good question, but not the question for today, because we still have a sizable on-prem business that we cannot ignore, that we have to continuously do a care and feed, while we have to show a great improvement in the SaaS space. So that's what I would say.
Thank you so much. The timer is showing me the card, so we are done with the question and answer session. Thank you so much, Shashank, and thank you so much, Raj, for this